This is Fast Eddie Chambers, and you're watching Guard Your Grill Boxing.
Big Mike from Guard Your Grill Boxing. We're in the heart of South Philly.
That's right.
Around the corners with Rocky Rand.
I don't get no plug. This Coltrane, baby. Come on, man.
That's my man, Coltrane.
What's up, Guard Your Grill?
We're at Johann's Gym, right in the heart of South Philly. We got a great interviews coming up. Chaz Witherspoon, and we also got Fast Eddie.
Fast Eddie Chambers fighting for the number one rights, the rights to be the number one contender for the IBF title, IBF champion, heavyweight champion of the world. And as he mentioned, we in Johann's Gym, you know, we emulating the gold star in the building. You, as you can see, Philadelphia gyms is all one big family. You know, we just go from gym to gym. It don't matter what gym it is because it's all one. So, you know, we here, man. This is what we do on Guard Your Grill Boxing.
What's happening, people? Welcome back to Guard Your Grill Boxing. It's your man, Sleep.
Number one boxing show on the dial. This your man, Coltrane.
We got a very special guest, needs no introduction. But for all who don't know, we got my man, Eddie Fast Chambers, number 16 in, ranked in the world, heavyweight.
Hold up, that's number one IBF contender in the world after he fight my man, Alexander Povetkin. On, was it January 26th?
January 26th.
Soon to be number one IBF contender in the world, Fast Eddie Chambers.
Fighting out of Philadelphia, we're gonna ask him a couple of questions. Now, Eddie, let's, because we do this show for the people, you know what I'm saying? We speak from a fan's perspective. How did you get started in this game that we all love called boxing?
Well, like I said, I wasn't the meanest guy in the world. It took a lot to actually get me into it. My dad actually pushed me into it because as I grew up, I was passive, like I just said, he wanted to make a monster out of me, make me somebody to be reckoned with in the hood back
That's
then.
What's up,
at right. this time, you know, I went, took me to the gym, you know, I really didn't want to do it, so I was looking to lose so I can get out of it. I thought I was going to lose. I didn't really have, I was about 13, 14 years old.
Okay.
And I really didn't have a lot of confidence in myself. I figured I'm going to lose my first fight, you know what I mean? So I can quit.
Right.
But I go in there and I won. And I stopped the kid, beat him up real bad.
Right.
Fought the next guy, I won. Stopped him too, bleed all bloody and everything. I'm like, wow, how's it? So all right, I'll keep going with it for a little while, but eventually right. I know I'm not going to finish it because I'm not really one of them kind of guy. But it just took off into something, you know, I never thought would happen, actually.
Yeah.
So now I'm here, you know what I mean? Hopefully this thing goes into a, balloons into a big heavyweight title, you know what I mean?
Right. Eddie, let me ask you this. The history of the sport, the father-trainer-slash-boxer duo has been successful, but at times it's been unsuccessful. As you know, Trinidad and his father works out well. Roy Jones and his dad didn't work out so well. Floyd Mayweather and Sr., as you know. Chris Bird actually has his whole family working with him. But that's what's up. Keep it all in the family. I guess my question is to you, because you know how dads can be. I had my father in my life, and your dad, you're well, a young man. I'm sure your father was firm on you. Let me ask you this. How do you decipher father versus trainer when you're in the ring? Or do you even decipher? Is it just one person when you're in the ring?
I think you do when it comes to the boxing ring. You got to really be focused on what you're doing. You don't want to have issues of you and your father's relationship, any family relationships, you know, whether it be your wife, your mother, your father, your brother, sister, whatever. You got to be clear-headed. So if you got to get in there with the idea of fighting. So if you do have a father-son boxing relationship or whatever, as father and trainer, you have to change. It has to become like he's my trainer. And when he comes to the gym, it's a totally different thing. Even if you live with him. You know what I mean? In this case, I live with him. So at this point, I'm helping take care of my family and everything. So when I go to the gym, he becomes my trainer. And I mean, I don't know him as my dad, even though, you know, I still say dad to him and all that. That's just like a, you know, back of my mind. But he's my trainer and my trainer only when he comes to the gym.
piggybacking off of that, do you feel like you leave, like you say, you're not the typical tough guy? Do you leave that persona, like when you, once you step into the ring, do you change into, you know, the boxer, the contender, Eddie Fast Chambers, and you leave your personality at the door? Is it the same type of thing once you step into the gym? Is it an on and off switch?
You have to go in there with a perspective. I got to take care of business. You know, it's a business attitude. It's not so much I'm mean.
Right.
You know, even when I get in the ring, I'm not necessarily a mean guy. I don't jump there and kill somebody. No, I mean, it's a business.
Right.
You know what I mean, and you have to do what you got to do to win. And if that means beat this guy into a bloody pulp, that's just what it is.
Right, you gotta do it.
I take my personality in the ring with me, but I check it at the door, basically.
Right.
Like, it's when I get in there, you know, I'm nice and I'm Virginia. I'll go in there trying to do dirty stuff, hit the guy low, you know, hit him in the back of the head, things like that.
Right.
I'm a gentleman, but I still fight hard.
You know, okay.
That's what I can.
Eddie, let me ask you this. They always say most great athletes are their worst critics. And just to look back on your most recent fight with Calvin Brock, I remember you saying in an interview, you know, I could have done better. I could have done more. What? You know, you want to elaborate on that a little bit, why you're so hard on yourself at times?
Well,
I saw you do it in some other fights before,
yeah.
But
oh, yeah,
that
mean,
was most recent, so, and that was televised. So,
I'll say me and my dad is my worst critic. But me, I'm probably worse.
Right.
You know, because I mean, I've done okay in a fight. I mean, it wasn't one of my greatest performances or nothing like that. I could have done a lot better. Given the opponent, I guess I was had a little more respect than me I should have, even though I acted a fool trying to embarrass him and make him feel bad at certain points because of some of the things he said or
because
of the fight itself. It's just, you know, adrenaline just in there. But I could have done a lot more, do a lot more punches. I think I could have stopped the fight before, you know, inside the distance if I would have picked it up and done what I really could have. So I give myself maybe a C+ B. Maybe. just because of the victory on such a big fight, you know, for me.
No doubt.
Eddie, take us to your, how did you end up in the, by the way, we're in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania.
Garger Grove Boxing.
Yeah, take us to how you ended up from, tell the people where you're actually really from.
Originally from Pittsburgh.
And how did you end up into the Philadelphia area?
Well,
with a great heritage of fighters.
Well, we first were interested in trying to get with Don King.
Right.
Because we seen that he made millions of other fighters, of black fighters.
And
we were hoping that he could do the same for us. But what happened was we ended up running into a guy by the name of Rob Murray Sr.
Okay.
And he was going to try to hold us into it. A nice guy, figured out us out. We were struggling, you know, in Pittsburgh. So we came up there. We met him at a fight in particular. We just watched him on tape. It was Andrew Sixes Lewis and Ricardo Mayorga fight.
Okay.
And we was meeting Don there after all the thing was over. I watched the fight, get a ticket to come and watch the fight.
Okay.
And we met with Don. And we heard him tell you, talk to him, it was nice, we were okay. Like, hey, it's Don King, you know, you do what you do, you let him cut you or whatever, that's on you. But then we talked to my dad, talked to him and said, you know what, man, you seem like you got a pretty good connection with this, you know what you're doing, so why don't you help us? And he thought about it, you know what I mean, got with his people and talked to his son and everything, Robert Jr.
Okay.
Of SCORE, and came up, watched me fight, saw some things that he liked, and now we're here. Worked a lot, really hard. He brought my whole family with me, you know, to this day, and supported us and helped us get to where we are today. If it weren't for him and my cutman Vinny, we wouldn't even be in this position.
That's what's up.
And you got a brother that boxed too, right?
Yeah, Steve. Yeah, Steve. He boxed.
Okay.
Yeah, he came up along with us, tagging along too, of course. So, you know, we all doing well, and hopefully some titles out there, some serious fights.
Who got the faster hands? You or
that's a close one. He's 140 pounds,
right,
so I don't know. We got to see.
You got lightweight hand speed.
I got lightweight. Somewhat, maybe middleweight.
All right. Middleweight.